If you want to take advantage of early sowing opportunities and plant a slow maturing wheat, either a winter wheat or a slow maturing spring wheat, you really need to change your agronomy and make sure that you've got the right setup to do that. So the first thing is picking the right paddock in order to do that. And the main thing you really need is low grass weed pressure and low disease pressure. So the best way of achieving that is through a double break. And that's a situation where you might have a pasture or a hay crop or a grain legume, and then the next year you have a canola. So you've got two good years of control on grass weeds, and you've also suppressed root diseases like take-all, and you're really set up to be able to grab an early sowing opportunity and go in and sow a slow maturing wheat without getting a knockdown on any of the weeds. The second aspect of management that you might have to adjust is being wary of some of the diseases that become a threat with early sowing. So barley yellow dwarf virus is a big one, so definitely look at putting an imidacloprid product on your seed before you sow and monitor for aphids into the season. Septoria triticae can be an issue, particularly in southwest Victoria, and that requires you to be a bit more on the ball with prophylactic fungicides and bring them a little bit earlier than you would for stripe rust. But definitely speak to your local agronomist about those issues. The recent research we did through the GRDC Water Use Efficiency Project and also the Early Sowing Project has really stressed how important it is to have several varieties of varying maturity on hand to maximise whole farm wheat yield. So if you've got 2 to 3 varieties of varying maturity, ideally one of them a winter wheat, you can take advantage of a sowing opportunity should it arise any time from late February through to May. So for instance, in southern New South Wales, if you've got Wedgetail and Gregory, Wedgetail being a winter wheat, Gregory a mid-fast spring wheat, you can take advantage of a sowing opportunity over a 3-month period by switching which variety you choose, and you maximise the yield of both by ensuring that as much of that crop is flowering during the optimal period. You can sow winter wheats for either dual purpose, where you graze it during the vegetative phase and then take it to grain, or for a grain only option. And you have to adjust your management depending which one of those you want to go. So if you want to graze, you really want to maximise your early dry matter production. So you want to have high seeding rates, 150 plants per metre square or more, and some upfront nitrogen to make sure there's a lot of forage on hand. However, if you're not going to graze, you really want to reduce seeding rates and defer nitrogen until after Z30, after the start of stem elongation, in order to keep early biomass production down and save water for later in the growing season. To adopt this early sowing strategy successfully, you really need to find out what varieties suit your environment. The best way of doing that is to go online and look at our GRDC update papers from 2014, which will be on the GRDC website. Speak to your local agronomist, they'll have a good idea, and also the NVT website.